All right, hello everyone watching on YouTube. This is going to be Hidden Cup 5 Finals. It's going to be me, Vasco de Hera, against Leary Komnenos. So this is the Grand Finals. They're about to begin. I'm going to go ahead and show you guys my start. Obviously, in-game, I will not be talking. I want to focus. I'll still have my cam there, so you'll still be able to watch. And it's going to be a best of 7, of course. Let me go ahead and show you guys a few things that you might find interesting. So obviously, we have the live stream here, which is really cool. Look at the hype. It's unreal. 34,000 hasn't even started yet. Very nice. I think we have Twitch front page. Hope that number gets to 50K maybe. Maybe more. Who knows? And then we have the draft here. These are the maps. 7 maps for me. 7 maps total. 3 for me. 1 neutral. 3 for Leary or Alexios. And then we have the Civ draft over here. I messed up the Civ draft a little bit. I'm not going to lie. But it still looks pretty good. Like, I'm not too worried about it. It's best of 7. There's still, a lot of chances here. It's not like the Civ draft matters a lot, but I would say it's a fairly even Civ draft. As far as what I think my opponent will do, these are my predictions, so we'll see if I'm right or wrong at the end of it. Game 1 is Evacuation, Mongols versus Dravidians. This is the sequence that I hope to see. So we have Mongols versus Dravidians. Game 1, I hope to win that one because I have a much better Civ as my first pick. If I win that one, he will see that I use Mongols. And if I know Leary correctly, I think he's going to want to bounce back on Bay, where he will use Mongols. And then I'm going to use Gurjaras. The reason I'm going to go Gurjaras here is that I want to try to counter Mongols with a weaker pick. If I lose, it's my last pick. If I win, it's a huge like upset. So I'm happy with that either way. And it's a decent matchup. It's okay. But if I lose that, no problem. After that, I'll go Arabia because I'm unsure if he'll go Chinese in Arabia. If he goes Chinese in Arabia, he doesn't have it for Mudflow. And if he doesn't have Chinese, I'm going to go Italians on Mudflow to counter his Byzantine. If I can't play Arabia first, I'm not sure if he does Chinese. I might have to go Magyars here just in case I have to fight Chinese. Magyars is my only chance against that. So that's going to be my general sequence. I'm going to win game 1. Game 2, if I win, amazing. If I lose, I'm going to go Arabia. And after that, we'll see what happens. That's my sequence of what I want to happen. But of course, in tournament and competition, it's not always like that. So we're going to go ahead and get started with the grand final. I don't think there's anything else I have to cover right now. That's pretty much it. And thank you so much for coming in to watch. And we hope that you'll enjoy the video. I'll be muted in between every game. Or during every game, you still have my cam, and I'll talk at the end of the game, give you guys my thoughts. Win or lose, it's okay for me. This is the grand finals. If we win, it's 6 S tiers in a row, which is amazing. Very grateful for that kind of streak going on. And if I lose, it's 2nd place. I'm super happy with it anyway, and I'm playing against a good friend. So if he wins, I'm just going to be happy for him anyways. So I'm not walking out of here a loser, no matter what happens in the games. And that is the best state of mind to have. So let's go ahead and hop right into the games with all that said. All right, let's get started here. First game about to start. I got Mongols. I will say as well before we get started, I have a lot of really sharp builds that I will be doing and really crazy plans. So I'm a little nervous. If they go wrong, it could be a disaster. If they go right, it's going to look cool and it's going to give me a small edge. So let's go ahead and do that and hop right into it with game 1.
Thank you. Amr Mindu.
Okay, that was amazing game one. But again, according to plan, we had to win game one. It was really good. We used our best civ. But I'm happy we took his Persians. I expected him to go Dravidians here. The fact that he killed his Persians were amazing. Dude, the first freaking moment where I was under his CC, I went to kill his vill, then go for a sheep, and then my spear bumped my scout. I didn't kill his vill. There's like a 1 HP vill here somewhere. I should have got that guy as well. I was greedy. I went for the sheep. That was my bad. But the rest of the game was really nice. I was scared of some archer pressure here, but it looked like he just went 2-dot galley to shadow in the water fast. Not a bad choice, but I think the water is... the rush distance is too long. So yeah, he killed my fish, but then I just ran away and it's all good. Okay, we'll go next game. Okay, next game he says let's go Mudflow. This is actually really smart from Leary. So as I said early in my plans, I want him to go Bay so I can see what the Raven Civ he wants to play. He's going Chinese. He obviously read me like a book. He knows I'm looking for that, so he doesn't let me do it. He wants to play Mudflow first. Now, if you think back to the draft, I have to guess if he's going to go Chinese or if he's going to do Byzantines. I think from practice, we all saw, to be honest, that Magyars were better than Chinese, but it's still close. Like, it's like 55% Magyars. Thing is, if he goes Chinese and I lose, I'm fine with that. So what I'm going to do, I think I'm just going to go Italians. And I expect him to go Byzantines here. If I go Italian and he's Chinese, I lose on the spot. But if he does that, then his Arabia Civ is going to be weaker. If I know Leary correctly, I think he's going to go Chinese for Arabia. And he's just using it as a mind game. So I'm going to try to not fall for the mind game. And go for the Civ that counters what he's going to do, which is Byzantine. I think he wants to go Spears into Water. And I want to do maybe just straight Water or just Scout opening into Water. Something like that. Maybe Archer opening into Water. With Italians, we'll see. But yeah, let's hop into it.
Thank you.
Yeah, that worked perfectly. My early game Cheese didn't do anything. He was really well prepared there with the scout and he walled it in, but I still walled in the lumber camp and made it messy, which is what I wanted. I wanted to take him off the clean game because I know he prepared clean game and I don't want to play clean game. If I play clean game versus Leary, it's really difficult. He's really good. Not that he's bad in messy games, but you know, just sometimes you get that psychological advantage. I know I'm going in with a messy game plan and he doesn't, so I'm ready for it and he might not be. So I used the element of surprise there. Obviously, I'm not just sending two of those forward YOLO. I'm sending them forward knowing that the meta is go take the middle wood, then wall with spears and water. And I want to get a step ahead of that by sending forward fills before the walls get there. That's a very nice game. And we won the mind game war as well. Now, he's last Chinese, so it's not like it's great for us, but we're up 2-0 and feeling pretty good here. Okay, next map is going to be Cup. Now, I don't have anything special planned. I've been taking the initiative the last two games. This one, I don't have anything planned, so we're going to go ahead, have fun. We're going to go ahead and let him decide what to do first, and I'm going to try to adapt. The reason I can adapt, I have the luxury of adapting here, is that I have top-tier Civ and very flexible Civ, so I have the luxury of being able to adapt. I don't need to take initiative here, but we have to react to his initiative and see what he does. And yeah, let's go. Let's go for it. Obviously, we're up 2-0, but we stay focused. Always stay focused here.
What time?
God, that was a good game. Wow. He played really well this one. His water gameplay was so good. I thought I can keep up with the scouts, but he added spears, which is really smart. Really made me worry for that one because the water was lost, and that's really annoying because when you lose the water, you lose all these buildings. So I was a bit stressed. I did 3 TC first, which is really a bit greedy, by the way. I think 2 TC plus siege push is much better. I could afford bow saw and horse call. I had to skip those two upgrades. So I was really hoping the push can work, and my God, did it work. It was an amazing, amazing push. Also, the monk staying in the two conversions here was really crucial. The knights running in and out was really really solid as well. This is why I don't really like the pike defense versus knights. The siege monks comes, and then the pikes are completely useless. Obviously, you get some for cheaper since these Dravidians, but it's a hard position. I mean, this is the weakness of Dravidians, right? When they have to fight on land, I always siege push Dravidians. There's no threat. They don't have knights, and they're kind of screwed. So on to next game. Okay, next one is High Tides. We have Malians here. I think he's going to go Lithuanians, but honestly, he still has Mongols. I don't think he'll go Mongols, so I think he's saving Mongols for probably Bay. So we have to still stay focused, because like he has, if he wins this one, he has Sivan on Bay and Sivan on Arabia. So I know I'm 3-0, it's looking really good. And, oh, I have to take the cat out. And chat is probably going crazy. Oh, it's going to be 4-0. It's not like that for players. Like, you don't think like that. You don't think it's over till it's 100% over. This is still super losable. So we have to stay focused here. Malians, Lithuanians. This is a very important matchup to win, because these are both civs that are kind of in the middle of the pack. So we're going to hop in here. Nothing special planned for this one. We're going to play a standard game. This will be actually the only like meta game so far, I think. We're going to play completely standard from home, most likely. But I'll adapt if need be. Let's hop into it.
Thank you.
Oh boy. We just won the tournament. We say alhamdulillah. Thank God. Praise be to God. Very grateful for this run. And yeah, it was a great final. Shout out to Leary. GG well played to him, man. It was some tough games. Actually, that last game was really close. I got really lucky. I snapped three of his monks. And that kind of won me the game. Lost the water. His build was way better than mine. But just had to adapt off it. And we were fine. I'm a little bit shaking right now. That was a big one. And you guys have to experience my emotion live here. Well, on YouTube. But this is how I'm feeling live. Epic stuff. Thank you so much for all the support, guys. I really appreciate you all. And I'll see you guys next time. Take care. Like the video. And peace.